Hi YouTube, hope you are feeling good tonight because we are making chicken cordon bleu. I have started with chicken breast, but it was too big, so I already halved it. It was huge, so I already halved it, and now I need to flatten it. I don't have a mallet, so I'm using a cast iron skillet. So I'm going to pound this out, and I will pound out all four pieces. And then I will be back to show you the rest of the recipe. Okay, so I have pounded out my chicken and I am going to season with house seasoning, both sides. And usually when I've been researching my recipes, they tell me to just use salt and pepper, but I'm more of a flavor person. I have to have flavor, so I'm just gonna use my house seasoning and we'll go from there. I doubt it will not be good, so. Okay. Also, I'm gonna do something different with Dijon mustard. I'm gonna use some Dijon. And I have a brush. I'm going to just do a little squirt. Just a little bit. Since we're using ham and cheese, I thought that that would just kind of be a nice flavor to go with that. So I'm just spraying that on. Okay. I'm trying this recipe because of my fiance. He wants to try it, and I've never done it before, so I'm trying something new. So we're both experiencing this together, you see. So I'm gonna wash my hands because anytime you're dealing with raw chicken, you wanna constantly wash your hands. Okay, as you can see, I rolled the first one, the first chicken breast. I stuffed it and then I rolled it. So here's the second one, I haven't rolled it yet. And I do have my chicken on a board. You never want to put raw chicken on your counter because you don't want to cross-contaminate. That's just a little tip for future reference. But I have laid down a piece of ham, a piece of Swiss cheese, and now I'm going to finish off with another piece of ham. And I'm going to roll this up just like this, just this way. And then I'll show you. Let me see if I can do it now. I'm just rolling. Just rolling. That's it. Just a simple roll. You see that? Just a simple roll. It looks like that when I'm finished. Just, I'm washing my hands again. Keep my hands washed. Okay, so I have put the chicken into an egg white mixture. Well, floured it first, excuse me. And then I put it into an egg white mixture. And now I am covering it with some panko breadcrumbs. Now this has sat in the refrigerator for about 45 minutes without the topping on it, just so the chicken will hold because I'm not using toothpicks. So I let it set for a couple minutes. But I'm just coating it with the breadcrumbs to give an extra crunch. If you don't have these particular breadcrumbs, you can, which are panko, I'm sorry. If you can't find panko in your particular supermarket, you can definitely use Italian breadcrumbs, or they can be seasoned or unseasoned. So it's really whatever you can find on hand. So that is really what I'm looking for, that it's coated all the way. And I'm gonna wash up my hands and get these in the oven. I already did the other one, so not in the oven, on top of the stove. Sorry. So let me wash up my hands and we'll get to finishing up this dish. Okay, so I put the chicken breast in the skillet and I just used a little bit of olive oil. I'm gonna brown them on all four sides. I just wanted you to see what progress we were making, and I'm gonna get ready to try to turn one and see where we are. pretty brown. And I made sure to put the side that was my opening, I put that down first to seal it off. And now I'm doing the other side. I'm gonna do all four sides of the chicken. So I'm gonna let that cook, and then I'm going to keep turning until we do all sides. Okay, so I have, let me cut this light off. I have taken them out of the oven, as you can see, and I am putting them in a 375 degree oven for about 15 to 20 minutes, just like I cooked all the way through. So I'm gonna start working on the side dish. I have not figured out what I'm gonna do yet, but at least I got my chicken done. Okay, so I told you guys that I was trying to think of a side dish, which I still haven't thought of, but I'm gonna make a sauce for the chicken cordon bleu. Traditionally, they use a white cream sauce, but that's not really, I think I'm gonna use heavy cream, but I think I'm gonna add vegetables, garlic, and some fire roasted tomatoes, just to give it a little something different and please my palate as well. Okay, so I've added the tomatoes. I only used about a fourth of the can because I'm just using this as a sauce. And I want that to just cook down. I'm gonna let all that cook down, the peppers, the onions, the garlic, and the tomatoes. And then I'm going to add a little bit of my chicken stock and my cream sauce. And I think just a little bit of salt and pepper, maybe some red chili flakes to give it a bite, and that'll be good for me. So that's what we're gonna do. And my chicken is coming along just fine. Yeah, man. Okay, so